my fellow Californians. I'm Wicked Wonka. This is going to be about the California gubernatorial race. Now, with the gubernatorial race, it's Gavin Newsom, the lieutenant governor slash former mayor of San Francisco, versus John Cox, a business person. Now, John Cox have run for office multiple times and lost the elections back then, but he's currently running for governor. Now, there's one thing about California's election system, the primary system. Now, the primary system in California is the jungle primaries. So basically you get in the general election, Republican versus Republican, Democrat versus Democrat, or Independent versus Independent. And as much as I know about the jungle primaries, it's usually the Democrats and Republicans that benefit from this. The third party seems to suffer. Now, with Gavin Newsom, he's basically Jared Brown 2.0. Or should I say, Jared Brown running for fifth term in this. Running for a fifth term, you know, for governor. And I'm here to tell you people, vote against Jared Brown. I mean, Gavin Newsom, because he's more paid by the corporations than... Okay, what I'm saying is that Gavin Newsom's paid by the special interests, the corporations, the financial institutions, and of course Hollywood. Well, I guess John Cox is not. Probably gets donations from people like we are. And, of course, the people that are funding John Cox's races, the financial institutions such as Citibank, the California Credit Union, and etc., as well as other companies and people like George Soros. So basically, he's Soros' candidate running for governor. And the reason why I'm voting against him, and I'm encouraging people to vote against him, is that he's basically going to continue the policies of Jerry Brown. Now, what do we know about Jerry Brown? Jerry Brown is the reason why California is the way it is, with the high crime, high taxes, high homeless population, and high prices of everything. Like, we have the highest state buy taxes in the country, while neighboring states such as Oregon and Nevada have no state buy taxes. It's cheaper to buy things up in Oregon or Nevada than it is to buy things up here in the state of California. Hell, it's even cheaper to buy goods up in Arizona if you compare it to our state, especially with the state buy taxes. Can you imagine some of the people up in Imperial Valley driving to Arizona just to go shopping for some basic necessities? Like, you need a new sofa, so you go down to Yuma, Arizona, because it's cheaper there, as opposed to like shopping in El Centro because of the state buy taxes. Hell, it's even expensive to live in California. most expensive place is San Francisco, which is impossible to live there. And that's basically, all Jerry Brown's fault, because with his stupid policies, like his gas tax policy, his, I think he has his recent policy where every corporation has to have a woman in their boardroom. And I guess the bigger the corporation is, the more women they need. So I guess all the corporations in this state are going to be moving to neighboring state just to dodge that bullet. So so there goes the title of being the fifth largest economy of the world. And what other policies Jerry Brown has made? Oh yeah, he supported a law that legalized infecting people with AIDS, as well as putting healthcare workers in jail for not using the right pronouns. You know, Scott Wienerton's law. Scott Peckerhead. And what else? What other fucking policies he made? I can't remember all of the policies. Oh yes, the water policy, where we have to use 55 gallons of water a day, which is near impossible, especially when you have a household full of 8 people. Household of 8 people and shit. Try doing that. And all these outrageous, stupid shit he keep passing, along with the legislators of California. Now, and I can guarantee that Gavin Newsom will continue his policies. He'll continue constructing that stupid bullet train to nowhere, as well as the water policy that benefits nobody. And all that. Now, this is kind of the reason why you should vote for his opponent, John Cox, because one thing about John Cox is that he's been endorsed by Donald J. Trump, the Don John himself, and I support Cox. Now, there are a lot of Travis Allen fans out there who wanted him to become the front runner of the party. Nominee of the Republican Party, you know, but I encourage the Travis Allen fans to support John Cox, because I know that most Travis Allen fans know that Travis Allen supports the First Amendment and supports the Second Amendment and is against the gas tax as well as the sanctuary state bill. Oh yes, one of Jerry Brown's policies, that stupid sanctuary state bill, which is more harmful to the state than it is, and all that. But John Cox is also in favor of these stuff. He's also for the First and Second Amendment, as well as against the gas tax and the sanctuary state. And he's willing to do much, willing to fight tooth and nail, take on these policies. And that's why we should vote for John Cox, in my opinion, because we need him to win. And for all you people out there, now there are people that are so black pill, so cynical that they think it won't make a difference if they vote for John Cox because Gavin Newsom's most is going to win. Now I'm aware that Gavin Newsom is most likely going to win because of the way this game is. But if you choose not to vote and be black pill, you are choosing to take it up in the ass like a prison bitch for Big Bubba and shit. Choosing to get fucked up in the ass because of how cynical you are. I want you to get out there and vote against Gavin Newsom, vote for John Cox. Vote like John Cox is about, like we're 5 points behind, or vote like we're 20 points behind, 20 points behind, so we can guarantee a good chance of a victory, or otherwise, we're gonna end up having Gavin Newsom as governor, and he'll wreck the state further down in the toilet. We gotta make sure John Cox gets a higher turnout. And plus, I'm not willing to move out of state. And a lot of people, I think right now, are resentful of the idea of Californians moving to their state because it's nicer. Because Californians are gonna be voting for the same policies that destroy their state. In fact, that's one of the reasons why California sucks is the people there. And because of that, it's gonna be a doozy. We end up with a situation where it's impossible to live in. Ungovernable. Now, if by miracle, if John Cox wins the gubernatorial race, it doesn't mean things get better instantly, because we got to deal with the legislator of the state of California. The legislation branch is full of lefty Democrats, as well as rhino Republicans who support Jerry Brown's policy and all this weird, wacky social justice shit. You know? And they will try their best to prevent Cox from passing any laws that make sense. Well, most likely he's gonna have to do like executive orders or something. Pass some common sense laws. Now, I'm not saying John Cox is perfect, but he's better than Gavin Newsom, in my opinion. And I guess when the 2020 elections, John Cox win, we can vote out the incumbent members of the California legislation and put in some common sense candidates. But right now, we gotta focus on voting for John Cox, and we gotta make sure he wins, even if the odds are against him. It's amazing, and of course, the social justice left are not going to make it any easy. It's like they're fucking NPC. It's like they're programmed to feel the same thing, get tapped. What I'm saying is, these social justice warriors you see around here in the state of California, they're basically programmed, it's like they're basically programmed to think the same way, to do the same way, to eat the same way, and have tattoos and piercings. It's like they're NPCs. That's what the NPC meme is all about. It's because these regressive social justice warriors are basically programmed to do the same fucking thing. Like their clone, you know, like the clone troopers after the Empire has been formed and been taken over by the Empire. You know, with Chief Palpatine becoming Emperor of the Galactic, of the Galaxy, the Galactic Empire. And of course, the social justice warriors like to think they're the alliance to restore the Republic. In reality, they're basically the clone troopers that fight for the Empire or the droid army. That's what they really are. And that's pretty much what it is. The left, they're very authoritarian. They hate the right. They hate the fact that people have free speech, the right to bear arms, and all that stuff that's founded on the founding principles of the United States. While there's a very vocal minority of us. So that's why I encourage you people to vote for John Cox. And vote against Gavin Newsom or any Democrat. Oh, people up in Massachusetts should vote for Shiva instead of that Elizabeth Warren character who claimed she was Native American just to get leverage for college, to get leverage along with the leftists. What a way to fake your heritage, and it's kind of funny that the Cherokee came out and ram her down, came out and browbeat her for that, Cherokee Nation. Of course, the Cherokees are Iroquoian, part of the Iroquois people, except they live in the Georgian part of the Appalachia. So, that's all I gotta say. Vote for John Cox and vote against Gavin Newsom. If we can vote for him, I guarantee we might win, might have a fighting chance to win the governor's seat. So I'm Wicked Wonka. I encourage you to vote. If you have any comments, leave my comment. If you have any comments, leave your comments on the comments section of YouTube or BitChute. You can follow me on Gab, Minds, and Twitter. And I suggest you pass this video around and make your own videos or post about the California election. So I'm Wicked Wonka. I'm